Hello, my name is Kurt Worley. I am the quantitative analyst at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Thursday, November 5th, 2009. This is your New York session video technical briefing. It's a video review of some of the things we covered in the live class today at fxbootcamp.com during the New York session. Now, before I get started, I'd like to request your feedback on this video. Whether you're watching this video on YouTube, or on fxbootcamp's Facebook page, or possibly from a link on fxbootcamp's Twitter page, or even on our blog, please leave a comment when you're done watching, even if you just say hi or thanks. That would be very much appreciated. Now, I'd like to clarify that the purpose of fxbootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. The currency coaches do not make trade recommendations. However, we do provide real-time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day. We assume that our newer bootcamp members are trading on a demo account, so that regardless of whether or not any particular trade plan is successful, they will certainly have an opportunity to learn and eventually trade their own live accounts for years to come, both profitably and independently. What you now see is a view showing three charts for the British pound US dollar currency pair as they looked at 7:15 a.m. New York time on GFT's DealBook 360 trading platform using fxbootcamp's custom layout. From left to right, a 15-minute chart, a 1-minute chart, and an hourly chart with daily pivot points and Fibonacci extensions of yesterday's range. You can see on both the 15-minute and 1-minute charts that this pair recently jumped up some 100 pips. From there to there on the 1-minute chart, 100 pip jump. In fact, the cable covered that ground in less than 1 minute of time after the Bank of England announced 15 minutes ago that it added another 25 billion pounds to its quantitative easing program. Now, quantitative easing means the central bank increases the supply of money by purchasing assets such as government bonds and corporate bonds. And in the case of in the UK, it would be gilts, government bonds. That is, an increase in supply of a currency is generally negative for that currency. However, in this case, most analysts were expecting a 50 billion pound increase in the so-called QE program for the Bank of England. Since that central bank is only injecting an additional 25 billion, that is less negative for the pound, or in effect a positive. So the good news is that we appear to have a clear bias on the British pound as we approach the New York session. In this scenario, you might decide to seek only opportunities to buy the British pound. The problem with buying this pair now is what we're out of position. By out of position, I mean we're too close to a significant source of resistance at 1.66. That is not only a psychological level, but it's also an area which has been repeatedly been a stubborn source of resistance over the past 5 months. This daily chart for the pair, known by most traders as cable, shows you what I mean by 1.66 serving as stubborn resistance, with the exception of this brief break of that level in early August. Notice how many times 1.66 is tested, even briefly pierced on occasion, but ultimately held. And most recently, just few days prior. So it's safe to say that that level presents a real challenge. I generally do not want to go long at or anywhere near 1.66. I would go long, however, at a level of support far enough below 1.66, which gives me enough room for a reasonably profitable trade, something like 40 to 50 pips on this pair. In fact, I drew up what you could call a what-if scenario before the Bank of England rate decision, which showed what such a buying opportunity might look like on a new scalp, for example, in a scenario which would be pound positive, such as the central bank not adding to its QE program. What I drew before the news release was a pattern something like this. A jump up to 1.66, respecting that level again as resistance. A pull back to the 1.65-60-ish area, corresponding to this recent swing high on the 15-minute chart, and then a rise up to challenge and maybe even ultimately break 1.66. What we got after the Bank of England rate decision was very close to that. The cable's rise after the news did stop near 1.66, as you see with this on this wick on the first 1-minute candle. Then it dropped to the 65.40 area, a little deeper than the 65.60 area I predicted, before rising. There's the dip to 65.40. Cable will ultimately rose back up to challenge 166. Now, if you were so inclined to check the trade the news scalp, you would have drawn a Fib study of the move from here to here. Then go long at the open of this green candle right here, following the bounce to 61.8% retracement of the move up in response to news. The bounce to the 61.8% Fib, almost to the pip, right there. Now, even if you did not take the news scalp trade, you can learn something from the post news price action. For example, there might be more to that bounce in the 65.40 area than just the Fib level of the 100 pip rise after news. If you trade this currency pair regularly, that level should ring bells for you. But even if you don't trade this pair every day, a scan backward in time on the 15-minute chart should reveal some interesting clues. This is a 15-minute chart without indicators showing most of yesterday's price action. Again, in this case, Wednesday's price action. One level should jump right out at you as having been important during two sessions on yesterday. The 1.6540 area was resistance during yesterday's London session, and then support during the New York session. Given that 65.40 was important on multiple occasions yesterday, and given that it held us support under high volatility conditions in the minutes following important news, it seems reasonable to conclude that it could hold again later as support. So that becomes a level at or near which you could plan to go long if cable returns to that level, particularly if other things which could also provide support converge at or near 65.40. Before the New York Open, cable struggles with the combination of daily and weekly R1 pivot points, which I've represented with horizontal red lines at the top of this 15-minute chart. And cable drops back down below 166. About 15 minutes after the U.S. equity market opened, you find the cable has returned to the 65.40 area. While this red candle here is forming, you should be assessing the situation. What more do you have going for you as sources of support at or near 65.40 is the question you should be asking yourself at this moment. Well, the 55 EMA, which I just pointed to, that's the upper sloping blue line on this chart. The 55 EMA on this chart is a source of dynamic support. Now, that's a start. That's a start in terms of additional source of support beyond 65.40. If I draw a trend line from today's low here, connecting with the higher low there, formed about an hour before the Bank of England news, I find that new trend line seems parked about 10 pips below that 55 EMA in the 65.40 area. On the hourly chart here on the right, I've got a combination of 21 EMA and 8 SMA sitting close to that trend line that I just drew. I should add that I've also got a Fibonacci level sitting near that 55 EMA. The 50% retracement of today's move up from bottom to top is represented by the horizontal bright green line. Even time of day can work in my favor here. As I just said, U.S. equity markets have just opened, and not always, but often with that comes added volatility in currency markets. Now, one simple way to define entry strategy in this case, again, to define entry strategy, comes from the 15-minute candles. After the brief drop below the 55 EMA and the 50% retracement level, then the bounce at the trend line, the moment you see green on this 15-minute candle, you hit that button, go long. That means you're in at or just below 1.6550. Your stop loss is parked just below the combination of 165 and the 200 EMA near the bottom of this chart, also the 786 retracement of today's move up. So your stop's down right about there for catastrophic protection purposes. And your exit strategy would be to take a loss of maybe 25 pips if price breaks below that trend line and the 61.8% Fib level. At the close of this green candle, you're in profit by about 25 pips. That's a reasonable point at which to move your stop loss to break even. As this pair approaches 166, you lock in some of that profit, say 15 to 20 pips. 1 hour after your entry, cable does manage to pierce the 166 level again, but the weekly R1 holds as resistance. Now, given the struggles this pair had with that level earlier, notice the wicks back here in the vicinity of that weekly R1. You may decide that this is your profit target. Again, the weekly R1 at 1.66, I just call it 166.20. If you close the trade there, you earn about 70 pips. Hey, not bad at all. If you held off for a bigger gain, unfortunately, you were knocked out soon before London closed, represented there by the red vertical line. However, you managed to make a profit. If you did manage to earn pips today, it was a job well done, given that the US dollar was mostly flat. Again, my name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your New York session video briefing from fxbootcamp.com for Thursday, November 5th.